Hello boys and girls, welcome back. So in this class we will be discussing one amendment question in our EIS syllabus chapter number 4, which is issues with respect to cloud computing. So exact question is pertinent issues with respect to cloud computing. So what do you mean by pertinent issues, sir? Pertinent matlab relevant issues with respect to cloud computing. Now what do you mean by issue? Issues are nothing but what? Now some people will say issues are nothing but problems, but better way of defining this word could be probable problems. Better way of defining this could be what, sir? Probable problems. Let me explain this question in this particular manner. Now imagine, sir, Chintu, and there is one Chinti. Okay, now sir, Chintu and Chinti, they were doing CA together. Later on, after clearing CA, sir, they thought, let us open one partnership firm. Okay, so they want to make this relationship a professional relationship. So they wanted to open one partnership. And imagine a scenario, they have gone to some advocate firm, legal firm, so that those advocate firm or legal firm will help them in forming partnership. Okay, so they will prepare that legal deed, drafting of deed, registration, etc. That advocate firm will take care. That is different thing. CS can also look after it. Anyway, so now tell me, sir, imagine this person, advocate, is yourself, sir. Okay, so we are that advocate. Now imagine, example ke liye, I am the advocate. Okay, now, so anyway, I am LLB also, sir. So imagine here they have come to me and said, what, sir? Sir, please help us in forming one partnership business. Now tell me, sir, don't you think when I am forming this partnership business, I will be preparing this deed? This deed should have many clauses. Agreed? Now tell me, sir. Sir, in partnership business, today relationship is good, there will be no issues. But do you think tomorrow these people can fight on some aspects? Answer is yes. In dono ke beech mein, don't you think differences of opinion can come? Answer is yes. So what could be the areas or on what points these two people can fight in future? So you may say that these two people may fight in future based on profit sharing contribution. Agreed? So say for example, future mein, Chinti is contributing more to the partnership firm and Chintu is not contributing to the partnership firm. So don't you think now they are having 50-50 profit sharing ratio, sir? So in future, Chinti might be saying what? Why should I share this much with you? You are not giving that much time to the office or that much time to our business, sir. So don't you think profit sharing pe jhagda ho sakta hai? Answer is yes. Sir, next on what they can also fight? Maybe capital contribution? Answer is yes. Maybe, sir, introduction of new partner. Imagine partner A is liking this, partner B is not liking this. So again, introduction of new partner pay, there is a problem, sir. Sir, there could be an issue saying what, if there is a fight, now each partner, one of the partners says what, let's dissolve. So can I say that could also be one of the problem, retirement of a partner. So aisa, check signing power. So don't you think, what are all these things, sir? These are some of the issues. Which partners can face in a partnership firm. Are you able to understand? These are some issues which partners face in partnership firm. So now tell me, sir, did they arise today? Answer is no, but they will arise today. Definitely they are going to come, sir. So don't you think these issues are nothing but what? Probable problems. So these are probable problems which you may face in future. Sir, tell me, sir, as a good advocate, sir, what is your job? Sir, you have to ensure that all these probable problems are taken care. All these issues are taken care presently itself. Hence, in every partnership, very clearly we will define all these clauses. So, profit sharing ratio, kitna hoga, how much time will be deviated, how much time will be dedicated, sir, whether a partner will be a sleeping partner or he will be an active partner, how much interest on capital, how much capital contribution is required, what would be the procedure for admission of a new partner, procedure for retirement of a partner, whether the partnership will be for a particular time or it will be a partnership at will. don't you think all these clauses very detailedly you write so that these type of issues you may not face in future. Are you able to understand what I'm trying to tell? Yes. Similarly, today, can I say there is one user and there is one cloud service provider? So can I say today user and cloud service provider are coming together? User is using the service. User is using the service of whom's cloud service providers. And so we are using the public cloud of cloud service provider. Now that service can be IaaS. We have already studied this. It can be IaaS. It can be platform as a service. It can be software as a service. Agreed? So it can be any service model, whatever it is. But we are using the service of cloud service. Now, sir, don't you think even user may face certain issues? May face certain probable problems in future. Do you think this is possible? Answer is yes. Hum bhi thode problems future may face kar sakte. So now tell me, sir. Sir, if at all, these are common issues. Now, don't you think all cloud service providers say this could be some common issues which may be there, sir. Now tell me, sir, today, if at all a new user who is taking service from cloud service provider, what he should do, sir? Don't you think these issues are to be properly be discussed? Can I say all these points pe you should properly discuss upfront, sir? You should discuss this upfront. Matlab, user should ask all these questions to the cloud service provider and should receive answers from the cloud service. All these points are to be properly be written in service level agreement. So you have to ensure that all these probable problems are taken care before you take up the service of what cloud service. I hope you understand. Similarly, for example, if a student who is taking my Google Drive classes. Now, EIS SM ke liye to I will not say, but yes, law ke liye hai na, I would like to talk about, sir. So if a student is taking my Google Drive classes for either CA Final Law or for CS Executive or CS Professional, sir, they're all law related classes, sir. Now, before he takes up the class, he will ask me some questions, hai na? So what could be the question? Sir, what about amendments? So how you are going to provide the amendments? What about materials? Sir, what about portion? And sir, these are some points which a student will ask me, sir. Don't you think all these questions if student ask upfront, so later on, hana, this type of problems he is not going to face. And don't you think as a faculty, I don't feel hana, anything wrong if student ask me these questions, because it is his right. So can I say if at all he is understanding, he is convenient, he is comfortable with all these points, then he may take up my classes. Otherwise, not, sir. So don't you think these are also some of the issues which a student can take after taking the drive class? And so don't you think better thing is what? Should he take up and then face the issues? Or these are some common issues which everyone knows, better discuss upfront and then take up the classes. This is the reason why ICA has introduced this question as an amendment. And so this is altogether a brand new question. Taja, latest amendment. Garam, hai na, which is introduced in our syllabus. So because ICA also wanted to know ki aap services to le lenge, you are going to take public cloud service either in the form of IaaS, PaaS, NaaS. So but you should also know ki what are the probable issues, which are the probable problems you are going to face. So now what ICA wants, sir, as a user, you should discuss all these points with whom? Cloud service provider. And then you should select whether you, then you should decide whether you should go with this particular vendor or not. Clear? So now, who is discussing all this with whom, sir? User will discuss all these issues with whom? Cloud service provider. Okay. So let us see what is the conversation which is happening between user and cloud service provider. So question number one, which user is asking to cloud service provider. What is the question number one? Threshold policy. What is what I'm using, sir? Threshold policy. Now, what is the threshold policy? from starting onwards in cloud, I was saying that कि cloud service provider, public cloud में there will be scalability. There will be scalability. Agreed or not? Scalability मतलब increase or decrease as per user demand. Yes? Now my question to you people is, now say for example, users. Okay? Now imagine this user is particular credit card processing company. Or any company, sir, and for that matter, any company it is. But this company is having a seasonal business. This company is having what, sir? Seasonal business. Now imagine year May, January, say lekar December we are talking about. Now say for example, these are the months where uptime is required. These are the months where a high capacity in cloud is required, sir. Say for example, February. And for example, this is Feb, May, say for example, what you say, November. Okay, so these are the 3 months where user requires uptime, sir. Matlab, these many days, even if you give 5 TB online, this is enough. But jaise it comes to February, and so January may you give 5 TB, that's okay. Jaise it comes to February, more and more customers will be there. Hence, on cloud, he required 20 TB. Okay, and then February khatam ho gaya, subsequently he will download himself. Now don't you think from 5 TB to 20 TB is what we want, sir? Generally cloud service provider is saying what, I will be scalable, not at all a problem, sir. Now my question to you people is, don't you think there should be a threshold policy? What should be there, sir? Threshold policy. Now what do you mean by threshold policy? If company may suddenly demand is increasing or suddenly demand is decreasing, how cloud service provider is going to react to it? So what a cloud service provider should do, and similarly what user should also do, sir. Now imagine if suddenly service is increasing, sir. So don't you think if suddenly service is increasing, obviously as a user you should intimate to cloud service provider what, ki boss, February month mein I will be requiring additional storage capacity. So don't you think this is the duty of whom? User, sir. User should intimate the cloud service provider. And what is the duty of cloud service provider, sir? Immediately he has to provide high-end service. Agreed? So this is what I mean by threshold policy. Matlab, how a cloud service provider and what user has to do. What user has to do, what cloud service provider has to do if there is a sudden increase and sudden decrease in the demand. And so as a situation may, how both these people has to react. So what should be the genuine answer, sir? Proper answer, user, you please intimate to cloud service provider, and cloud service provider, as and when you receive the request from the user, immediately you have to do it, sir. So don't you think these are the points which you have to write in service level agreement? The cloud service provider is going to be scalable only if, what they say, request comes from the user. So is it say what will happen if this type of threshold policy you write in the agreement, sir? Is say what will happen, sir? Can I say there will be a clarity between user and service provider? Otherwise, most of the time, what may happen, you know, user will be assuming what scalability, and automatically he will look after. For example, sir, take example I would like to tell you. Sir, in a hotel, imagine two friends were there. So these people have ordered a plate of manchurian. Nice. Now imagine suddenly if three friends have come, matlab, imagine they were going by. Nearby they were there, so they saw these two people eating manchuria, so hi karte aa gaye, sir. Now they all sat on the plate, sir. Sir, half an hour over, 1 hour over, abhi tak manchuria has not come, sir. Now these two people started scolding the waiter. Now what will waiter say? Mere ko kya malum bhai, hai na, if these additional people have come, you should have told me, no, I want one additional plate of manchuria, I want two plate of manchuria, aapko bolna chahiye. You did not say, I did not provide. So don't you think user is thinking that automatically the plate of manchuria will come, and waiter is thinking what, he did not say, why should I provide, sir? So don't you think this difference of opinion might be there? Yes. So better thing is you disclose this threshold policy. Clearly you should mention ki sudden increase or sudden decrease at that time, how you are going to react. So don't you think this clarity is required upfront, or it should be subsequently after you avail the cloud services upfront? So point number one. Dekho, threshold policy. It is a policy for allocation of resources to whom, sir? Matlab, Google is having resources. Now how he is going to allocate this resource? Now this type of problem comes when if there is a sudden increase and sudden decrease. Right? So mostly threshold policy will tell how these resources are to be allocated. So now you may ask me, what is the main objective of having a threshold policy in SLS? The main objective is there should be a clarity between whom, sir? User also and service provider. Both should know what they should do. And if sudden increase is there, sudden decrease is there, what they should do. For example, sir. Now imagine a scenario, February month may you have taken 20 teams. Now in March month, you don't require this. So don't you think if you don't require, again, you should intimate to the cloud service provider, yeah, I want to downgrade my service from 20 TB to 5 TB. You should intimate. Imagine if you don't intimate, what will happen, sir? Again, he is going to bill you for 20 TB. And suddenly, subsequently, there will be a fight between user and the service provider. What will user say? Are you can see, no, in March month, I have used only 5 TB ka service and you have given me the bill for what? 20 TB. So is this a good thing or a bad thing? Very bad. So as a type of difference of opinion, nakko, better you disclose this in the threshold. I hope you understood. So second discussion now. What should be the second discussion? Second, you can say unexpected behavior. What is the second point they have to discuss with them, sir? Unexpected behavior. Now, what do you mean by unexpected behavior? Let us understand in this manner. Now, sir, imagine user. Now, user was having some of his software, some of his data. Now, that software, that data was lying in his particular device. So, it was there in his laptop or device, etc. Now, what did this user do, sir? This user has now used cloud, sir, and he has uploaded all those softwares and all those data in the clouds. Okay, very good. So, what is that I am trying to tell you, sir? Before using the cloud services, all the data was lying in his laptop or in his desktop. Now, he has taken the cloud service. So, he has migrated all these things, he has shifted in the cloud. In future, when he was using the software or when he was downloading the data, sir, now what he has observed is data, the format has changed and software is not performing properly. So what is that you are trying to see? Now what he is thinking, as long as this data was there in my laptop, it was functioning very well. And jaise hi it has gone to the cloud, it started behaving in an unexpected manner. It started having some bugs in it. It is not opening properly. Usme technical errors aa gaya. So this could be also some of the complaints or not, sir. Yes, most of you might be having this complaint, sir. Ki jab tak, as soon as as long as data is there in my device, it properly, jaise it comes onto the cloud, it starts behaving in an unexpected manner. Sometimes file does not open, file gets corrupted, sir, if I download, format gets changed, some texts are not visible. So these are some common problems which majority of the users were facing when they were using cloud service. So now don't you think, Mr. User, who is now availing fresh cloud services, sir, don't you think he should have clarity on all these things? And imagine if cloud service provider says, no, sir, there will be no unexpected behavior. Still, he need not trust, sir. Sir, he can always go for a pilot check. What do you mean by pilot check? Dummy check, sir. Sir, he can upload, he may use this software on a trial basis. Say, for example, he may ask, no, still I want to use this cloud services for 7 days as a trial service. So he may upload his file, again he will download just to check whether the file which was behaving properly when it was there in his laptop, and they say the file is uploaded on the Google Cloud, whether both are behaving in the same manner or not, sir. So don't you think, ASA, if you are confirmed, then only you better make this trial version as a real version. Otherwise, you not subscribe to that cloud model. Don't you think this could be also one of the good way of solving the issues? Right? So second point could be what, bacha? Unexpected behavior. Whether your files which are there at cloud, whether they will behave in the same manner or not. And if there are unexpected behavior, what could be the solution which you will. So better thing is what? Why you should go for corrective actions? Better, whether unexpected behavior is there or not, you go for a pilot check. Clear, bacha? So first point is over. Then I have discussed sixth point. So first point we have totally discussed. Now let's see sixth bit. Okay. In some instances, an application programming application performing, sorry, in some instances, an application which is performing well at company's internal data center, or you can say at company's device, may not perform the same way in the cloud. That is, they behave in an unexpected way. So what should be a better solution, sir? Therefore, before hiring any cloud service provider, organization should test the application in the cloud. And how you will test this, sir? Pilot study. Now, what is pilot study, sir? Dummy trial check. I say you should go for something called trial. Agreed? So as a situation may, you should decide, sir. Now imagine if trial check may be unexpected behavior are there. So first you should fix the problem. First you should fix the problem before executing or before opting the cloud. Okay. So is say what will happen, sir? These issues you may avoid. It's simple. Why ICI is highlighting all these problems, sir? Because ICI wants you people to avoid these problems. What all common problems which people are facing, ICI do not want you also to face. So people are facing threshold policy ka problem. People are facing unexpected behavior ka problem, which ICI do not want you to face. Similarly, most of the time, to attract the users at start May, they will be giving you very, very offer prices. So cloud service provider will be saying what? Ki you will be getting the services at $9.99 per month. $9.99 per annum, and star mark they will be putting. Sir, as a user, what we will be seeing, ki array $9.99 mein amarko 10 TB online mil raha, 5 TB I am getting online per month, I have to pay only $9.99. It's a wonderful offer, we take up. And after 1 month, what happens, sir? $9.99 ke saath, I will be getting some additional cost. Additional cost can be in the form of database application, in the form of what? Application running during the peak time. Like Ola may you will be having, sir. And sir, peak time may they will be charging you more, sir. Sir, or additional storage cost they might be asking. You said this much, but subsequently it became this much. So don't you think this type of kirkiri we don't want, sir? Hyderabad may isko hum kirkiri bolte. Issues ko, if at all I have to tell you in Hyderabadi language, it is but kirkiri. So we don't want this kirkiri. Sir, we want these problems to be discussed upfront. And goal, $9.99 star mark. What is this star mark? Then you should properly discuss this, ki what you will be living. Sir, $9.99 ke baad, any additional cost is there. So he may say, sir, additional storage, we will take this much, this we will take this much, this we will. Sir, imagine all these things is coming additional 500. Sir, if user is okay with that, he may take up. If he is not okay, then can I say next cloud service provider? So this is your third issue. What is the third issue, sir? Hidden cost. So whether your cloud service provider will be charging anything. So this is also one of the question which user should ask to whom, sir? Cloud service. So here, who is interacting with whom, sir? User is asking all these questions. Whole threshold policy. Will you incorporate threshold policy or not? Imagine he says yes. Okay, very good. Whole unexpected behavior is happening. Achha, he says not happening. But still, I want to do trial checks. Third, hena, you may also ask for any hidden cost. Fourth point, sir. Now, sometimes what may happen, sir? So, third point we have seen what, sir? Hidden cost. Now, fourth point, sir. Sometimes what may happen? Now, imagine, sir. Sir, as a user, you have gone to a particular cloud service provider and you are using his cloud services. Okay? So, aapne use kiya, 6 months tak you have used, sir. But every month, and matlab day by day services say you were not satisfied. So last May you thought what? No, and let me migrate from Amazon to Google. Let me migrate from Amazon to Google, sir. So can I say now you are thinking of migration? Now you are thinking of migration. So when you are thinking of migration, sir, don't you think when you migrate, do you think you will start this cloud afresh? Or you would also like to migrate this data. You would also like to migrate this. So don't you think as a situation may, what should happen, sir? Sir, Google, now tell me, sir, if you have to migrate the data from one cloud to another cloud, don't you think if you remember SaaS model may, I have used something called API, an application programming interface. So there should be a proper integration between this website to that website. Agreed? Now. Sir, now Google will have its own API. Google will have its own API. API मतलब application programming interface. Similarly, every website will have its own API. So Amazon will also have its own API. Now imagine a scenario. Amazon is like, we don't support the API of Google. We don't support the API of Google. Because I told you, sir, you require now integration. So whose API you want, sir? Because Amazon has to integrate with Google. So Amazon should have, matlab Amazon should understand, or Amazon should have the API of Google. Sir, imagine Amazon does not understand, or Amazon does not have any support for API of Google. So isse kya hoga, sir? User will find very, very difficulty in migrating the data. So don't you think, aise situation mein interoperability, what this issues is called, what, sir? Interoperability. What do you mean by interoperability issues, sir? Whether data migration will happen easily or not is what we are talking about. So sometimes every website may have their own formats for inputs, own formats for outputs. So iska output and iska input, if they are not matching with each other, so don't you think now, you have to, sir, lifelong stick with this cloud service provider. Sir, this is called vendor lock-in. What is this called, bacha? Vendor lock-in. Sir, your cloud service provider has done something whereby you cannot go with new service provider and you don't want to continue with existing. So na ghar ke na ghat ke, kada kuda ledu akkada kuda ledu, hai na? So you are nowhere, matlab aapka tiny fish, hai na? You are fasak. This is what it is. So don't you think you should also ask whether your cloud and other cloud are interoperable, whether you people are having that support to, what you say, migrate the data, sir. So let's see interoperability. It refers to ability to move resources, your application software, your data between service provider. What do you mean by between service provider? Amazon to, okay, next. If a company outsources or creates application with one cloud vendor, the company may find it difficulty to change to another computing vendor. What could be the reason, sir? Sir, reason could be what? APIs. You are not able to integrate the APIs, sir. And also, there are different formats for importing and exporting. So don't you think? Now, imagine a scenario. Microsoft says, sir, we don't have any interoperable issue. Matlab, we support all different cloud service providers. So don't you think better would be what? Go for Microsoft. Why? If you like, you will continue. You don't like, hai na, you can easily exit to other service provider. So don't you think this would be a better option rather than what, bacha? Amazon. Agreed? So again, this is a point which user should have clarity upfront. I hope you are able to understand. So what is the fourth point, sir? Interoperability issue. Whether they will be handled properly or not. Clear? Next. Sir, next, security issues. Now, this is more common. Can I say public cloud mein? This is one of the biggest point which you have to talk about. Now, what is this security issue? Let's understand. Ab dhyan se sunna, sir. Sir, user is having some data or some applications where in his device. Now tell me, sir. Before I discuss this, now imagine you are having a bike. So don't you think you will handle your bike in a more better manner? But imagine a scenario, you are having others' bikes. Imagine your friend's bike you have taken. Don't you think you will not handle that bike in a better manner? Aap usko roughly use karenge, sir. Why you will use in a roughly manner, sir? Because you are like nade enti, hai na? So imagine a speed breaker hai, koi break nahi, sir. Thakam leko, hai na? Padte padani, gire to girne do, koi problem nahi. Puncture hota hone do, bike kharab hota hone do, because it is not mine. So don't you think people tend to be careless? People tend to be careless if resources does not belong to them. People are more careful if resources belong to them. Agreed? If it is yours, you will be more careful. If it belongs to others, you will not be that much. Agreed or not, sir? Yes. Simple. Sir, for you, sir, for you people, hai na, CA exams are CA exams. For me, your exam are exam. Bas, can I say for me, your exam are exam. For you people, exam. So can I say these exams are very, very important for you, not for me. Right? Main toh already pass ho gaya. So don't you think the way I think, the way you think is different. Similarly, here also, sir. Here, what is happening, sir? For a user, his data is very, very important. His data is very, very confidential. Agreed? Now, sir, what he is doing, sir? This data he is now putting on cloud. So this data he is now putting on cloud. So don't you think, jaise he puts the data on the cloud, now in his mind n number of questions. What is the question, sir? How I am managing my data, will cloud service provider also manage the data in the same manner? Ella nenu na data ni treat chestunano, cloud service provider kuda na data ni alane treat chestada. So how you will manage the data, sir? So data management, don't you think this would be one big issue with respect to security? Agreed? Similarly, sir, if any hacker hacks the cloud, then what will happen? So can I say sensitive information may be hacked, and so this is also one of the fears, sir. Yes, and third, sir, na data cloud service provider chustunadu whatever naina amute, can I say you will again have confidentiality issue. Sir, you are believing that ki cloud service provider may use your data and give it to the company. Don't you think this could also be one of the question in your mind? Imagine if cloud only not functions, any hardware, any software fail aithe, hai na, if cloud fails em avutundi? So don't you think these are n number of questions who is having, user is having in his mind, ki whether what type of treatment he will give to our data, sir, whether sensitive information can a hacker hacks, then what will happen, sir? Sir, whether these people will use the data of ours and give it to some others, that is confidentiality, will they maintain or not, sir? Sir, what will happen if cloud fails? So don't you think these are all the security issues? So better thing is what, as a user, you ask all these questions up front and ensure that these things are properly defined in your service level. Agreed? So this is also one of the issues. Dekho, security issues mein what are the points I told you, sir? First point is what, sir? Management of data. Matlab, how much important I am, how carefully I am managing my data, will you also manage the data in the same manner? Sir, insider attacks. Whether hacker, if they attack, what you are going to do, sir? Sir, will you maintain confidentiality of my data or not? Matlab, you can see the data. Will you give this data to outsider? What will you do if at all your cloud services? So don't you think these are some of the issues? Clear? So now tell me, sir. Sir, what should be the remedy for this? So responsibility. Service provider must ensure that infrastructure is secure. So you should try your level best to ensure that infrastructure is secure. What you can do? Better thing is encrypt the data. Better thing is encrypt the data, sir. And try to follow as many security standards as possible. Sir, as a customer, what you should do, sir? Always ensure that service provider is taking proper steps with respect to security. You should always, in a 2 months may, 1 month may, you should always check whatever security procedures they are providing are up to the mark or not. If not, you please keep on intimating the cloud service. You should be after the cloud service. This is how you can maintain security. Clear? So this is your fifth point, sir. So can I say interoperability is over, security issues are also over. Next, we are talking about software development in cloud. Now tell me, sir, if you are developing software in the cloud, obviously you are going with PaaS model. Obviously you are going with PaaS model, sir, because sir, cloud service provider is giving you hardware plus tools for developing the software, and you are now developing the software, sir. Agreed or not, sir? So here what they are trying to say, sir, user is developing applications where in the cloud. So don't you think at that time cloud service provider may have given proper tools for developing the software? Okay, but don't you think application software may, now tell me, sir, you have developed the software, development is over. Now don't you think day by day risk, IT risk is increasing or decreasing? Is increasing. New threats keeps on coming. So obvious logic is you would also like to upgrade your software, sir. Now tell me, sir, if you are trying to upgrade the software at that time also, you would like to have tools from the service provider. Imagine at that time if it does not give you proper tools, if it does not give you proper tools, so don't you think developing applications, upgrading applications will become very, very difficult. So don't you think this is also one of the question which you should ask to the service provider? Ki bhaiya, aap wo tools barabar denge, sir, we will be very dynamic, sir. Whether you will also be very, very dynamic, whether you will also help us in upgrading the software, you know? So this is also you should ask, whether your application development process will be flexible enough, and will it help us in upgrading? This is one question you ask to the developer. Sir, this was one point, and in fact most of the points are taken from some foreign textbooks only, sir. This was one point which was taken from some research. So there was one research which was conducted by Journal of Internet Service and Application. So there, if you can see, they were talking about different issues in cloud computing. So PaaS may clearly they have specified this particular issue which we are reading in our material. And Hyde says ICI ke jo board of studies members hai, who were involved in drafting the material, they did not even change a single word. Jaisa it was there in this particular study, in the same manner they have put in our material also. You can see from the perspective of application developers. Sir, from the perspective of application development, now you can see our material also, sir. Dekho, from the perspective of application developer, developer face complexity of building secure application. Again, you can see from the perspective of application developer, developer face the complexity of building secure application that may be hosted in the cloud. Ekdam, exactly what is there here, same to same, mucky to mucky is there in our material also, sir. Okay, so second para also peacefully you can see. Now anyway, you can pause the video and compare it. So here what is that we want, sir, ki whether application development process will be flexible enough, because if it is flexible then only we can develop secure application, otherwise we can't develop. So this is also one of the point which we talk about, and this problem you will face only in PaaS model, because there only a software provider, that is a cloud service provider, is giving you tools for developing the software. Okay, sixth point I already explained you, bugs removal. Now simple, so can I say cloud service provider is having itna bada data center. Now when you are handling itna hardware, software, etc., small small bugs will always come. Now the question is whether you will be solving these bugs upfrontly or not. Say for example, sir, when we are having when we are taking this wedding hall on a rent, sir, so can I say when these many guests come, so always they will keep on throwing glasses on the floor, sir. So don't you think what we want is cleanliness, sir? But that doesn't mean glasses people will not throw. People will throw. What we want is whether that hall provider will provide a service boy who will maintain the cleanliness. So as soon as somebody throws it, this service boy should collect it and keep it in the dustbin. Same thing is, see, bugs will happen, but only thing what commitment we want from service provider is whether he will be helping us in removing these errors. Okay, so this is also one of the issue. If at all he does not help you in removing the errors, if at all he does not remove the error, can I say it will create problem to you, because you are using the cloud. And last is legal issues. Now what is legal issues, sir? Sir, if we are using the cloud services of a particular vendor, so don't you think we want that you cloud service vendor to comply with all the legal laws of your land? For example, ab dhyan se sunna, what is it I want to tell you? Sir, if you remember Companies Act 2013, if you have studied, sir, there is this act allowing you to maintain books of accounts digitally. Answer is yes. Can you store the data on the cloud? Answer is yes. But there is a condition. What is the condition, sir? The cloud should have, whoever is your service provider, whoever is your cloud service provider, he should have his data centers. He should have his physical data centers in. Agreed? No. Sir, imagine a scenario. You have taken the service of one particular cloud service. Now he does not comply with legal laws of your country. So don't you think this could be one of your legal issues? Now you will start facing non-compliance of Companies Act. Again, necessary penalties as per Companies Act will be. don't you think as a cloud service provider, now as a user, you should ask the cloud service provider, okay, you are providing services to many countries, that is good. So whether you will be complying with the laws of our lands, and and better thing, what cloud service provider should do, sir, he should give confidence to all the people saying that as many laws are there in what is a different world, we are complying with all the laws because we are having presence in different parts of the world. Now tell me, sir, Google will say that our user will be limited to only India? Answer is no. So can I say if 190 countries are there, 190 countrymen will be using the services of Google? So obvious logic is Google is having presence in 190 countries, so Google should comply with laws of all the land. And so you should ask the question and Google should clarify. What you should ask the question, whether you are complying with all the laws of my country. And what should Google do, sir? Because you are having presence in multiple countries, also comply with all the laws of the land, sir. So dekho, cloud systems need to adhere matlab follow several legal requirements, privacy law and data security. And this law will vary from country to country. So as a user, you should check whether they are following or not. And as a cloud service provider, you should ensure that whether or not user asks you, you should follow. Okay. So these are some of the issues which cloud service may you may get, sir. Clear? So 8 points are very, very important for this particular example. So how you can remember this answer, sir? How you can remember this answer? So here you will remember like this. This cloud software, what is what I'm using, sir? This cloud software behaves unexpectedly. So this cloud software behaves, as it is behaving unexpectedly. Question is why? Because of bugs. Okay, again, what you should remember, sir, this cloud software behaves unexpectedly. Why? Because of bugs. So what you should do, sir, these bugs you should remove. If not, what will happen, sir? Legal issues will arise. Again, what you should say, sir, this cloud software behaving unexpectedly. Question is why? Because bugs are. So what you should do? You should remove these bugs. If I don't remove these bugs, what will happen? Legal issues. So how you will remember, sir? Dekho, T stands for threshold policy. I have arranged these points also in the same manner. No need of writing anything. T stands for threshold policy. H stands for hidden cost. This THIS. Threshold policy, hidden cost, interoperability issues, security. Threshold policy, hidden cost, interoperability issues, security issues. Sir, this cloud software behaves unexpectedly. So can I say unexpected behavior is what your fifth point is. Unexpected behavior is what your fifth point is. You can see unexpected behavior is what your sixth point is. Clear, bachcha? So now can I say 5 points are over, sir? This stands for what, sir? T stands for threshold policy, hidden cost, interoperability issues, and S stands for what, bacha? Security issue. Okay, so this cloud software behaves unexpectedly is your fifth point. Software, and you can see here, software development in cloud, this is your sixth point according to me. Or you can say this is your fifth point and this is your sixth. Clear? So 6 points you will easily remember by remembering this point, small point, sir. This cloud software behaves unexpected. So this is equal to 4 points. Software is equal to software development in cloud, and unexpected behavior is behave unexpectedly. Clear? Now, so what you should do, sir? Why it is behaving unexpectedly? Because of bug. So what you should do? Remove the bug. So can I say bugs removal is 7th point. Legal issues, I hope easy way may you will understand. Remember, sir, too many memory techniques will not solve the problem, sir. So try to have that memory technique which is scenario based. So can I say here these are 3 points ke liye you need not put effort. Why you need not put efforts, sir? This, yes, you have to remember, but other what you say, 1, 2, 3, 4 points easily you'll remember. Legal issues only. Bug removal only. Behaves unexpectedly or unexpected behavior. software development, you know, software development is complex. Can I say 4 points? So easily you remember issues. Now this may, can I say starting point hint you are getting, maybe threshold policy, aisa you can remember. 6 points, if you are able to remember, that would be great, but try to put efforts to remember all the points, because exam may, we don't know, hai na, how many points we are going to. So if you can remember, if you read 8, maybe exam may 7 you will remember, 6 you will write properly, so that you can score your 6. Okay, so with this we conclude all related questions of cloud computing. Hope you have understood and liked this. Okay, thank you very much.